tonight I'm gonna talk a theory. I haven't made many theories out lately. This is a little bit about the pineal. Actually, it's all about it. The pineal gland, where we have this mystic, this imagination, all of these things going on in there, our inner eye. And yet, I believe that many of us have further capacities, further skills. And yes, I have a really, really different background tonight, don't I? I mean, I have my curtain. Anyway, yeah, we have different skills, and what I mean, more higher level mystical skills. I believe that this whole work, I will call it the work cycle, that's pretty much been generated as a force have to since, I can't say the Romans, I can't go back to 3,000 years ago, I can't go back to even, I guess, there was a 3,000 to 5,000 time with the Chinese, where they were really hitting the work cycle pretty hard. Yeah, but when we are into forced work, okay, not when you're just going out to gather your nuts as normal, and that's not forced work. That's a work that you do under specific, you know, light restrictions. It's day, it's night. I don't go hunting out at night. I mean, I would never have done that. But here now, in the last 5,000 years, we've become we have to work late sometimes. Many of us have to work into the evening hours, past the sunset. So here now we have candles. We have candles, and we're like, now we're learning to write and scribe all these things on scrolls. And you know, before we were tapping on stone, and we were doing that pretty much in daylight. You know, it's a different mystical brain. Okay, now a reason I'm saying we're different now, I believe we were robbed from the time frame. I believe our inner eye is happy-go-lucky in daylight, is happy-go-lucky in normal hours. But when we're forcing our eye, and yes, our pineal is accessed through our eyes also. You have to remember, all this light is going in through our eyes into that mystical. So now, when all of this is happening, here we have computerization, you know, let's run it forward 5,000 years, we have computerization, you know, and we are really just like, wired to this thing. And you see a lot of people now, they're like, when I look at like regular human beings, you know, from 20 years ago, before the computer, to now, they're like different types of children. They're just different, like really different. Like they get hyped extra fast. I find myself get hyped on this machine. We get computer revved, and I'm not saying it's necessarily a computer. It could very well be the light that is hitting into our brain, and many of us are working late on these machines. Okay, so all of this is in a way damaging our mystical center. You know what I'm saying? So here it was before, and I'm like, whoa, I'm asleep now, I'm asleep, and yet no, I have electricity light here, I have the computer screen light. It's all damaging me. You know what I'm saying? It's damaging my mystical. The intuitiveness our basic intuitiveness, you can go back to the shamans when they're talking about, tapping into the psyche of an animal, tapping into their psyche from a distance. All of those things, they just are like a not happening any longer. We're not having that same connection, that same importance of connection. Animal-human connection is just not as important in that way. Where before we wanted to be, we wanted to be the horse, we wanted to be the bear, like really, like when we meditate, we were really the bear, we were really the horse, we were really the wild marmot, all of those things, we really became it. Now it's just like everything is just like a flaky surface. Flaky surface snapshot of, I'm going to be a marmot in modern dance and dance around like a marmot. It's just like this little flippant routine rather than the real, I'm really going there. And having that attunement cycle, that brain connectivity, So that's just my theory, is that we have completely blocked our brains from mystical occurrences more and more and more and more by the light show that we are feeding and robbing ourselves of, and so thereby aging ourselves sooner. So all of these things are going on, because I'm getting the light show, constantly the 4th of July in my eyes after nightfall, it's the 4th of July, all that excitement, all of it, you're going to burn out, we're just going to burn out quicker. Sometimes I feel like I'm 80 years old. I am not kidding you. Because of my time spent on this machine, on these computer machines. I really ramped in around 1996. That was it. Heavy. Me, eye, and screen. And that was it since then. So I don't know how many years that is, but I feel like it's a robber. And it's robbed part of my sensitivity acumen with mystical happenings. So, anyway, that's it. It's a little pineal clutch we can all think about. Are we losing? Are we losing? Look at it. And it even gives me a wrinkle in my eye, the light is too much. It's just too much for us. I just think it hypes us out. It turns us into wackos. I don't think it's supposed to be that way. But the work cycle has pushed it to such. The work cycle. Work, and then you die. As the Germans say. And definitely after sunfall. How scary. Because I think what we would be like, when I talk about, our brain expansion, and people are like, let's take whatever, this or whatever to expand our brain. I think we would be that way naturally if it wasn't for all of this hookup of forced eyeball communication after hours. And during the day, we're having some serious forced eyeball communication. Like, I force you to look at this light. I'm forcing you to look at this light beam. you know, all these light beam forcing. He's like, what the heck? You know, think about it. It's just like cattle prods into your eyes all the time. You know, you think about what it's doing to your master skills there in your pineal. Just completely shredding you, isn't it? Anyhoot, that was it. That was it. Did I have anything else? I lost the keys to the five new doorknobs, and then I had to get the keys done again. I had to pull them all out. It was very humorous, but anyway, I survived. I survived, and I was a tyrant yesterday over it. Those types of things, you know, the immaturity that just came out of me. I'm blaming the machine. I'm blaming all of this light stress that is damaging our brains. Gosh, well, who would we be, you know? How far would we think, you know? Would I be just talking to a whale right now, you know? I just feel robbed by this civilization. Just robbed by this computer machine, by the candles, by the electricity light, you know, by these little telephone things. Look at me. Yeah, all of that enforced learning, we're forced to learn the words, forced to learn the books, forced to learn and training our eye exactly as such to the books, into the rhythm of the languages or the rhythm of this or the rhythm of that. That robs your brain of going into those other expansion areas because you're just really training entrainment with that one sector. So, anyway, yeah, shaman to you. Yeah, we gotta get out of this thing, and more often, much more often.